An HR manager of aviation startup at Dubai, UAE, I'm going to give a short presentation on the topic internship. Internship are future investments for the students as well as for the professionals. As we all know that internship is really important for the student as well as for the professional for their career development. The word internship is being arrived from the Latin word French as well as from the French as well as from the Latin word. The word intern means to gain the experience while working in some particular industry or a firm and after then joining some good organization as well. Starting with my first slide, an internship. Internship is a good opportunity which is basically given to an employer or the employee, or it is also provided to the students who are undergraduate or postgraduate for a fixed period of time so that they can enhance their skills and gain the experience in the industry they are working in. The internship can be paid as well as it can be unpaid. Internship plays a very important part in a career. Internship gives you an experience in a career field to pursue. It also prepares them in the field and it also helps to groom the confidence in which they are working. That is why if a person or a student or a professional is getting him or herself to be in a good internship, it can boost their career as well. The history of an internship is associated with the medical field. As we all know that intern word is being derived from the French as well as from the Latin word. If the student is getting himself to be interned in a good organization, he or she may get better experience or the skills in which they are needed for to enhance their career for the future growth. So the history of internship has been come from the medical background. In that time, the doctors in the late 16th and the 19th century, the doctors in the medical field are having the degree, but they don't have their license. So in order to get their license to work as a professional, they have to get self to be intern in somewhere. From there, in the late 1940s, the word internship is being derived and it has become mandatory for all the people in the academic to get themselves internship to be in a good place. For an internship, what a student or a professional basically needed. Organizations, as we all know, that organization requires a particular process or the formality for any academic education. Internship, if a person is going for an internship, he or she also need to go to a process. That is, he or she may need a formal application, a resume, a cover letter, transcript, 2 or 3 letter of recommendation, essay, and the reason that why that particular person is being interested in that organization to get themselves intern. Because if a person is interested in for the internship, he or she has a career objective and the motive of working in that particular industry. And often in the process of hiring or selection depend upon the organization by checking their resumes and the application if they are selected. Now we all know that internship, we all know the history of internship, we know that where the internship word is being originated and why it plays an important role in the academic career. Internship is divided into paid, unpaid, partially paid, and many more types. Paid internships are basically for the professionals, or it can also be given to the student who are pursuing their post graduation in the academic years. They get their stipend, they get their money in the form of stipend in the organization they are working for, and they also get the pre placement offers if their internship working culture is fit for the organization as they wanted for their interns to be presented. And unpaid internships take place in the graduated students as it can add their academic tradition towards their career, like the BBA students or the any graduated student can go for unpaid internship. So yeah, as I told that internship are a variety of type. It can be paid, it can be unpaid, full time, part time, partially. So let us see that what are the type of internship the corporate or the industry or the firm is organizing for us. First is inside internships. Inside internships basically are the internship for the larger corporations or the investment banks, in which they set up service or programs for their clients and for a number of days or for a week, so that they can get an experience to work for a particular project. Next, paid internships. Paid internships are those internships which are basically related to the medical field, architecture field, engineering, law, business, management. Who are pursuing these courses, they go for the paid internship and they get the stipend as fixed by the organization and depending upon their work. Unpaid internships, as I told you, that unpaid internship are the internships which are basically run for the students who are under graduation, and it added to their academic accreditation as well. Partially paid internships are the internships which also termed as a paid internship, in which they get a stipend and it depend upon the working performances of that particular person, that how he or she is performing in that internship as and whether it is fit for that organization or not. Some other type of internships are internship for a fee. Companies in search of interns often find the students to be paid and unpaid internship. But some reputed company like Reliance or Infosys, all the IT companies or the big renowned MNCs, they provide the internship for a fee as well, because in a form like they provide the incentive if their working performances is nice as up to their ratings, and they also provide the PPO offers with a better stipend amount too. University level work experiences internship are those internships who are pursuing their PhD or who are pursuing their high level of academic education, like in medical field or a PhD field. There they have to go, or in the advocate field, any field it can be, where they can work under some professional person to get themselves boosted in that particular field. There are two terms. Now, after getting through the internship, there are two terms, internship and apprenticeship. Internship, we all know that what is the importance of internship and why it is really required for the professionals and the student to boost their career. Now, what is the difference between the apprenticeship? Apprenticeship is a dedicated vocational program in which the student not only gain the experience while working in some industry, but they also spend some hours to keep themselves updated with the knowledge in order to get the national vocational qualification, where they work for some days as a trainee and for the some day they get the knowledge from that center. As you can see from this slide, it reflects the meaning of apprenticeship, where it is mentioned that apprenticeship is something where they get an NVO from the particular place. Companies, basically corporate culture, provide the internship because they only hire the students who are having their better skills in the competitive environment, who have the spirit of keen learner and a dynamic nature as well. So companies provide short-term and long-term internships to the employees as well, depending upon their projects in which they are working. Short-term internships can be given to the student who are pursuing their management courses, and if they are providing their time to in any organization, there they get a short-term internship, and PPO is also offered depending upon their performances. And long-term internships are those internships which they provide to their employees internally for some projects, so that they can give their best to that particular project in the particular time. Now, what are the experiences you required to need for an internship? I hope that these slides can provide a better insight about the internship. Experiences is a really important part for a particular person in an academic growth. Experience can increase their career and also increase their incentives and salaries as well. Experience plays a very pivotal role in the particular academic career. For an internship, the experience is also required. Let us see what are the ideas that a particular person should have to gain an experience in an internship. First, volunteering internship. Hello.
Yes, go ahead. Don't
okay, sir. Okay.
Things are pretty well. We're doing very well. Don't worry.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So yeah, voluntary internship. Voluntary internship, volunteers are those who get the ideas to put themselves front forward to any task or any work they have been provided in organization as a leader or as well as in a team. So volunteering is an excellent, as you can see from the slide, volunteering is an excellent way to build your experiences. Don't think about the work being unpaid, but as we all know that many times the many good companies doesn't pay the stipend to the students. So their main motive is not to pay the stipend. Their main motive is that if they hire their interns as a PPO form, then they should give their best as to their organization. So that is a good idea to gain an experience in an internship. If you are doing well in an internship by giving your best, then you may get an opportunity to be placed as a fresher in a good organization. So there you get a better experience in an internship as well as for the job. Second, there are part-time jobs there where you can work for some time or and for the other time you can learn also some other thing. That also plays another part to get an experience in an internship. Internationally and nationally, in both cases, the ideas and the experience plays a pivotal role in an internship. Students, club association, community members, they can also get an experiences for the student to get an experiences in an internship. Freelancing is also a great groom for the students where they can go through this freelancing programs and they can get an experience and how to deal with the clients. Basically, in the marketing field, if a person knows how to pitch a client, then they can go for freelancing and gain an experience before joining an organization. There are many benefits and challenges that an intern has to face. Benefit is that they can gain the knowledge. Obviously, if you're working in a good organization, you can get a better knowledge and skills. You can have a different roles. You can work in a dynamic culture because if you work in any MNC, you have a heterogeneous number of people with a different culture. So you have to deal with that. You have the opportunities to make a social network because networking nowadays in a digitalized era, the networking plays a pivotal role. Everything is going to be digitalized. So we have to keep our network broadened. And secondly and lastly, it also provides you the experiences. How you can apply for an internship? To apply for an internship, you should know the reason, your objective, for what reason you are going for an internship. What are the skills and motivation you basically required for an internship? What in which organization you are interested? Is your skills is meeting to the organization where you are getting yourself to be interned? So these are the things that how you just apply for. You have to check these things before going for an internship. If you join the internship in a flexible form, then it may create a problem to your academic career as well. So one should be very rash, should take a rational decision before joining as an intern in any organization. As I told you that how you have to, in very first of my slides, that how you have to write or go for an internship, you have to provide a cover letter. The cover letter explains, now I'm going to tell what is a cover letter. The cover letter is an opportunity where you should provide your introduction and in the position you are interested, in the role you are interested. It may add to your CV and also to your area or the skills in which, so that the HR of that organization can go through your resume or the cover letter and take your interview and select in that company for an internship. These are the steps that you need to be followed for an internship. That is starting by a formal general overview. You have to research for the company in which you are going for an internship. You have to keep updated yourself with the corporate world. You have to know that where you are working, the whole history of that company, its pros and cons, its turnover, its benefit, its award, its accreditation, everything. Once you are done with your research paper, you can write your cover letter for an internship you are being interested in. You can get the internship opportunities either by the advertisements, or you can also apply for the internship through LinkedIn or through any social media sites. But before that, you should see that your skills can meet up to that organization's skills, and you should have been updated to that company fully and thoroughly. लेकिन ओके नाउ आफ्टर नोइंग दिस थिंग वी शुड नाउ नो दैट व्हाट आर द थिंग्स मेनी टाइम द स्टूडेंट व्हाइल अप्लाइंग फॉर एन इंटर्नशिप फॉरगेट दैट मेनी थिंग्स व्हाइल गोइंग फॉर एन इंटर्नशिप लेटर दे फॉरगेट मेनी थिंग लाइक दे प्रोवाइडेड टू मेनी वर्डी थिंग्स टू फैंसी इंग्लिश दे यूज टू राइट इन देयर कवर लेटर और द एप्लीकेशन इन फॉर द इंटर्नशिप दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग सो द थिंग्स दैट अ पर्सन शुड रिमेंबर टू नॉट टू मेंशन इन देयर कवर लेटर एज इट कैन क्रिएट अ प्रॉब्लम टू द एचआर इट प्रोवाइड अ बैड इंप्रेशन फॉर द पर्सन हु आर रीडिंग योर कवर लेटर और द एप्लीकेशन और रिज्यूमे सो यू शुड नॉट प्रोवाइड सम टू फैंसी वर्ड इन योर कवर लेटर डोंट write those things which you are not be the real as whatever you have whatever skills you are you should write and mention those skills don't copy and paste many students or many basically the student used to do this thing that they used to copy and paste the thing from the social sites and then they provide their resume to the HR which is really throws a very bad impression so you have to be real whatever the skills you are having you should provide those skills in the cover letter So yeah, internship as my topic here, it is my topic like why internship are the future investments globally and nationally. So yeah, because it can increase your knowledge. It can get yourself to be known. But there are many reasons that if a person is getting himself or herself in a good internship, he or she may gain better knowledge, better experiences, as I told you. It also boosts the confidence. They know the insight of a corporate culture. What are the dynamic changes can arise? They also know that thing. It also strengthens your resume. If you are getting yourself to be in a good internship organization, your resume will reflect that thing and it plays a very digitalized or you can say offline in any mode. If you're just switching your job, it plays a very important role in if you're joining to some any other organization also, if you have done internship in a good place. Internship nowadays can be due to is COVID-19 the internship getting themselves to be virtual but earlier they also organization provide offline internship is something where the student or the professional go through an organization for the fixed period of a time and there they learn many things and virtual internships are those internships where they don't have to go anywhere they just sit on their desktop or the laptop and they can get the knowledge through virtual internship offline or virtual internship which is better according to my point of view both internship has its pros and cons if we see that offline internship provides better pros apart from cons but their virtual internship provide cons as well in apart from pros because virtual internship the student cannot go to that organization cannot gain the experiences and while in offline internship they can go to the organization and gain the experiences so that is more better in my point of view to get themselves to be offline intern stipend is as I told you stipend is something that is paid to the trainee for a fixed period of a time so that they can work in that company they can give their best but one should remember one thing that if a student is joining an organization in the mindset of getting better stipend then he or she is really wrong stipend plays a pivotal part in an internship but he or she doesn't have the motive that they may get the stipend from the organization or not they should focus on providing on gaining the experiences and to provide their best in that company stipend is important but it should not become the priority of a student to just join the organization only for the purpose of stipend or the stipend purpose only stipend are of many types like academic research health insurance wherever you do your internship you get your paid stipend many companies nowadays provide paid stipends so that they can get a better interns and the interns can also be get motivated so it is a thing of both sides both of them get benefited by this internship stipend as I told you if a student is or professional is working in any organization or any in a company he or she may get a stipend for a fixed period of a time and they also get the PPO if their working performances is really nice but then I again say that the intention of doing an internship is not should be of getting a stipend only you should focus on your experiences and the skills try to nurture many more things that an organization is providing while your internship so that is the reason that you should do an internship in a good organization so that your resume can be strengthened your confidence can be increased and it also add to your career as well some disadvantages are there also. As we all know that everything has its pros and cons. Disadvantage of doing an internship can only be this, that if a person or a student is not so much focused in its career and he joins any organization which is not so focused, does not have any mission or vision in the future, and it is very flexible, then it can create a problem to the student in its academic career. So it's really important for the student or a professional to keep themselves updated and to keep themselves interned in a good organization. Many challenges they have to face in a company, but to overcome that challenges, they have to gain the confidence. They have to be real. They should not provide the things which is out of the box. Due to COVID-19, many organizations go through the virtual internship. As we all know that nowadays the digitalized era is being arrived. COVID-19 provides a better internship, although it provides a downfall to the economy, but many industries are there where it increases its career. Like many education companies are there who boost their turnovers in this COVID-19. This virtual and digitalized era boost a gain in amount of turnovers in this COVID-19. They go to the virtual internship. They have provided virtual internship to the professionals, to the student, everyone, so that the loss cannot be occur. And we should also have a ability to learn and adapt the dynamic environment and to be a keen learner. So virtual internship is a better opportunity provided by the organizations to us, and we should grab that opportunity at the first go. At last, after you have completed your internship in a good organization, you got a certificate from that company or organization. If your performance is really remarkable to that point, you can get a PPO. And if it doesn't have that remarkable performance, you get an internship certificate. Internship certificate is something where it is approved by the organization that he or she has completed so and so days of as an intern in the organization, and their performances are good, or whatever their remark or rating should be according. Depend upon the company, they provide a certificate of internship, and you can add, which can add to your placements when you are joining any company finally. So there are some pictures which you can see from COVID-19 or virtual and offline internships. So that's it. Thank you. I hope now internship is important and plays a future investment globally and nationally. You all know that, and I hope that you will join the internship.